President Biden has called for America to defeat domestic terrorism. Is this the start of a new war on terror? Welcome to America Uncovered. I'm Chris Chappell. Please support the show by liking this episode and subscribing to America Uncovered on YouTube. In the wake of the Capitol riot 2 weeks ago, there's been a renewed spotlight on the issue of domestic terrorism. And President Biden even mentioned it in his inaugural address.
Now, a rise of political extremism, white supremacy, domestic terrorism that we must confront.
Shalom, shalom. All praise and honor and glory to Yahweh, Baha Hashem, Yahweh Shai, Baha Hashem, Rakaha Kadash, and Abuhana to Zael, then Apostle for the Mason who do well, a peace, a blessing, a salutation to you, Akiam, who are pushing these tools to the four winds of the heaven, a being on the forefront of this spiritual war to make sure Jerusalem is established as a place here on earth again. So it is another lesson, you see, about the clutches of the devil, man, you see. You see, so, man, Sleep Joe is not sleeping actually, like many people they used to say or to call him Sleep Joe, but this dude, it doesn't seem like he's going to sleep anytime soon. So, it is another episode of news and prophecy coming to you through the spirit of Yahweh Baha Hashem Yahushai. And in this episode, we are going to look upward as a tight measure, you see, which are coming, you see, to fight domestic terrorism. As that is a point you need to bold it down. So they mentioned extremism, white supremacy, and domestic terrorism. There is three categories of people. So white supremacy are those which stormed the capital, and you have extremism, peoples like Black Conscious and whatever, you see, and you have domestic terrorism. That's going into the prophet, man. You see, the devil is strict, man. They actually, if they were direct, they could have said, instead of domestic terrorism, they could have said the prophet, or black people who scream in the corners, man. So, amen, this don't need a deep breakdown. Grabbing up scripture and concept, no, man. See, this is persecution that is coming, man. See, the devil know that he have a short time. And as the scripture tell you, how will you simple and love simplicity, because those go hand in hand. Persecution is coming, and you people still love simplicity. You see, you still wanna find a spot in this society. You wanna get attached in this society, man. So let's continue listening.
And we will defeat. To overcome these challenges, to restore the soul and secure the future of America, requires so much more than words. It requires the most elusive of all things in a democracy. Unity. Unity.
Biden made several stirring calls for togetherness and unity in his speech. Unfortunately, virtually all Americans missed that message because we were too busy making Bernie Sanders memes. At least we were all doing it together. And within 24 hours, the Bernie sitting in a chair meme had become a Snapchat filter, a bobblehead, and an official Chairman Sanders sweater from Bernie himself, with all proceeds going to Meals on Wheels. Now that's a display of good old American ingenuity. What was I talking about again? All right, domestic terrorism. Yeah, I also wish I could just spend the rest of the episode showing you Bernie Sanders Photoshop next to puppies. Lots of puppies. Sadly, this is America Uncovered, and not Puppies Unleashed. So, Biden has vowed to defeat domestic terrorism. But the how is the hard part. Because, say it with me, it's complicated. First, there's the issue of how the term domestic terrorism has been politicized. Here's the definition of domestic terrorism according to the U.S. Penal Code. Domestic terrorism means activities that A, involve acts dangerous to human life.
So in that way, the domestic terrorism, you better believe that it's talking about you who go outside to preach. That's why throughout the year, the apostles, the elders and the brothers on down, they were like telling you that we are risking our life to go in the front line of this spiritual war, you see. And if you were scratching your head to understand that concept, wait, that same statement to be put into action. You see, when the crackdown comes to you people who are listed on blue list and I think it is blue and red, you see, and red list, and the crackdown is coming, man. You are domestic terrorism, you are extremism and white supremacy. And all of this is a guise to get the profit. See, so let me see. A really quick scripture. Let me grab a really quick scripture. It's actually, this is Revelation. Let me get Revelation again. Revelation 12, I think it is and 12 says, therefore rejoice, ye heaven, and he that dwell in them. Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and of the sea, for the devil is come down unto you, having great wrath, because he knows that he have but a short time. You see, how does the devil know he have a short time? Because of the prophet. Not because of hurricane, not because of chemtrail, not because of the South China Sea conflict, not because of Iran making nuclear weapon. It is because of the prophet. You see, the nation have been making nuke since the 1970, man. You see, but the difference between the 97 and now, man, the elect like now, we believe through the spirit we have Hashem Yahushua are sealed, and actually Esau can see that through his witchcraft. I don't believe. Let me get a scripture, man. You see, like how the spirit is on yours to discern is that the elect have already been sealed. The same thing with Esau, man. Through the left hand side, Esau know, man, the elect are about to be sealed. That's why he know he have but a short time. So this is Nahum 3, let's see, verse 4. It says, because of the multitude of the whoredom, the well-favored harlot, the mistress of witchcraft, that sells the nation through her whoredom, and the family through her witchcraft. You see? That's Esau's widow, man. Through the left hand side, he know that like now, I mean, he